how to make it work for him. So cheers to Joe Rogan. Let's go on and jump topics. Let's move over to Athlon. Now, Athlon does their college football preview every year. They've set it up for you to pre-order their college football preview for 2020. They are ready to rock and roll, and with that, they have put out their projected final top 25 for after the 2020 season. This is how they think it is going to end up, and I'm going to go super fast. We've got six SEC teams here. 25, Iowa. 24, Virginia Tech. 23, Boise State. 22, UCF. 21, Cincy. Number 20, Minnesota. Number 19, USC. Number 18, North Carolina. 17, Iowa State. 16, Texas. Now we get into the top 15. Number 15, Michigan. Number 14, Oklahoma State. Number 13, Auburn. Number 12, Wisconsin. Number 11, Texas A&M. I found that a little crazy because there is a strong chance A&M is 10-0 going into the last two games of the year against Alabama and LSU. For them to finish 11, they would probably have to lose both of those and win a bowl game, I guess. And even then, they still might be top 10. Number 10, Oregon. That was a little surprising to me. What are your thoughts on that? They've got Anthony Brown transferred in from Boston College. Oregon as a top 10 team this year after losing, you know, a ton on defense. They lose their quarterback. You know, they do have a transfer quarterback coming in. Oregon as a top 10 team seemed maybe reaching a bit. Does that feel like it to you?
I have no opinion about this. This is your topic. This is your segment. I think this is the dumbest thing on the planet.
I enjoy the early top 25s.
Before the season starts, we know only like six teams in the whole country have a chance to win it all. So the only thing that we do to check are they ever right or not is, well, oh, they picked Alabama and Clemson 1-2 and Ohio State 3. So they're pretty good at this, right?
Have you looked at this?
They're absolutely not good at this. This doesn't mean anything at all, ever.
Matt said they should not even rank teams until about week five.
This is the dumbest thing that we talk about, but it's something that Gary likes. So yeah. Go ahead.
And we've got a lot of people that do pay attention. So number 9, Notre Dame. Number 8, LSU. Number 7, Georgia. Number 6, Florida. They think Florida is going to be better than Georgia this year. Now we get into our top 5. Number 5, they've got Penn State. Found that a little surprising. I don't know that they've got the quarterback to be able to do that, but, and here's the top 4, and you haven't looked at this at all, have you?
Mm-mm.
But you can already tell who the top 4 is going to be.
Alabama, right? Clemson, Ohio State are going to be 1, 2, 3. I don't know who you, I haven't paid attention to who you've said and who you've not said, but I'm sure there's a big name team that you didn't mention already that's going to be there.
Yeah. That would be Oklahoma at 4.
Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah. That sounds great.
Of course. So, Oklahoma 4, Ohio State 3, Alabama 2, Clemson 1.
Nobody knows who Oklahoma's quarterback is going to be, but that's fine.
Well, it'll be Spencer Rattler. And he was the number one quarterback in the country coming out 2 years ago, you know. This is his sophomore season.
Couldn't beat out Kyler Murray. Couldn't beat out Jalen Hurts.
Well, no, he was coming in right after Kyler, but he couldn't beat out Jalen last year. So, or no, maybe he's a redshirt sophomore. Either way. Let's see. Ben said, why is Oklahoma State so high? Because they got a ton of dudes coming back. I mean, they got, you know, at star wide receiver coming back.
Because
it's
all done on paper. That's why they're so high.
Yeah. That's it. They got a ton of talent coming back, guys coming off injuries, et cetera. I mean, we'll see. And they've got a reasonable schedule this year. Like, there's no reason they shouldn't win 9 games this year. Matt said it's hard to say a team beat a top 10 team week 1 and then that team sucks the rest of the year. Then the team that beat them gets credit for beating a top 10 team. Yeah, they've changed it up a little bit as it's gone on. Michael said, I agree, Matt. At the end of the year, they give teams credit for beating ranked teams early, and they're no longer ranked as high or even ranked. Last year, they kind of changed that up a little bit. Because honestly, like, LSU beat, what, 7 top 10 teams last year? Like, 11. At the time?
11.
11 top? That's impossible.
Shit, I just made stuff up. Who cares? What does it matter?
They beat 7.
They beat the hell out of everybody they played.
Yeah, they beat 7 top 10 teams at the time that they were ranked.
Yeah, but Texas, sorry, Matt, Texas is not a top 10 team.
Right.
They weren't close to a top 10 team. We beat the shit out of them, and it didn't matter.
So, and then Alabama, when you guys beat Alabama, was ranked number 3, and then at the end of it, they were number 13 going into the playoff, which is insane, but it's still, correct. The rankings are insane.
Correct.
So
they played two good teams throughout the regular season, lost both games.
Yeah.
I don't know what you're supposed to do with that.
I mean, I guess, okay, you got a valid point. You got a point. So
did you beat a ranked team the entire year?
No, but we didn't lose to any unranked teams either. I mean, they lost to okay. lost to LSU right. and lost you at got Auburn.
Credit for not losing to a team worse than Memphis. Good job. Good job. We'll give you a gold star. We'll make you another silver coin that you can have.
I'm good on the silver coin. It's all good. And it wasn't so. I think it was bronze or something like that. McKinnon said, "Beat the hell out of everyone but Auburn."
Shitting on your coin again, man. Can't even just let it be.
No, it wasn't silver. It's what I'm saying. It was like
yeah,
it was
but nobody
some kind
knows
of,
that, and nobody cares.
Just oh my
let
god!
It move on. It's a fact that doesn't change anything.
I'm really just my wife.
Matt's gift.
My wife got on to me about that, by the way.
Yeah.
About like just random details that don't matter. I don't know why I do that. Been doing it for years though.
All the time.
Michael said top 25 ranking is all about making those early week games have better ratings. Yeah,
but I mean, hang on. I'll argue with anybody all day long. Alabama playing USC. Alabama doesn't have to be ranked number one preseason to make that a good ranked rating.
A good matchup. Yeah.
Like that's a terrible argument. Does the team have a big following? Is it a big school? Then they're going to have – if Notre Dame was ranked 28th instead of 9th, guess what? Their first game of the year still going to be a pretty big matchup for television ratings.
100%.
100%. Like ratings care about fan bases and followings, not rankings. I'm just going to argue that to the end of life. It doesn't matter.
There you go. Matt said it's a bronze coin. And then he said, I'm getting that thing back. You have to come in from Texas to get that, buddy.
Come on. I'll help you.
No chance.
I know where you stay.
I got locks on the doors, bruh. It's all let's move off the top 25 here. I think it's pretty common. Until Saban moves or Dabo or Ryan Day or whatever, you're going to have Alabama, Ohio State, Clemson in the top four.
And it doesn't
from now
matter
until the end
because
of time.
That's not where they're going to finish every year.
Yeah.
Because last year Alabama was number one and they didn't finish in the top 10.
Exactly.
So what?